Well, good news, everyone. We're not done shopping. We've got a lot more to do in today's show, but I'm going to pivot just a little bit and talk about something everyone, and I mean everyone, seems to love: podcasts. It's kind of the thing now. Well, the Coco team is exploring what podcast producers are talking about in our state. Here's our next Colorado Pod Story, just a special. It's all about the joys and challenges of foster parenting. Here's my interview with producer Natasha Pepperell. Well, fostering a child is one of the most beautiful things we could possibly do as human beings. Natasha, it's such an honor to talk to you this morning.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm really excited to be here.
Well, it's a wonderful thing to talk about. How did you first get involved in fostering and becoming a foster parent?
That's a great question. So I first became involved in foster care actually as a foster care volunteer. So I volunteered at something that a local human services department held, which was called like Kids Night Out. And it was just a time for caregivers to drop kids in care off and then get a few hours to themselves. And I'm a little embarrassed to admit, I was a little scared at first, you know, of quote unquote foster kids and just how society paints them. But having that firsthand experience, I saw that at the end of the day, all kids are just kids. And I was also able to see the value in having kids be able to feel valued by adults in their lives. And so then I was really inspired to become a foster parent.
That is absolutely incredible and very inspiring. You've become very passionate about the whole fostering system and why it's such a great thing that you talk so much about it, especially in this podcast that we'll get into in a bit. But why are you so passionate about that?
Yes, I'm so passionate about foster care just because after becoming involved and learning more about the dire statistics of kids in care, I just saw there's so much room to improve. Most of my experience in foster care has been with teens and tweens in care, and the stats of kids aging out of the system, like I said, are just really dire. Most end up living on less than $8,000 a year. Many end up homeless or in jail. And these kids really do deserve better. And so I wanted to be part of that solution.
Yeah, you know, I think a lot of people are genuinely curious as to how they could be foster parents, what work is involved, and this is something you talk about in the podcast. Can you tell us about Just As Special and what kind of topics you cover and how that could be so beneficial for people who could be interested in it?
Right. So I started the podcast because when I was going through foster parenting training, I just really wasn't able to find any foster care podcasts that I felt I could relate to, especially being a woman of color. So we're actually the only active BIPOC-hosted foster care podcast. I host it with my sister, who is a foster care volunteer. She also volunteers in a women's prison where she works with many moms who have kids in foster care. So we really just wanted a podcast that shared a lot of really diverse perspectives. So we center BIPOC perspectives, LGBTQ plus perspectives, multi-religious perspectives, non-religious perspectives. And it's because personal stories are really what motivate change. When people are able to hear the really powerful and raw stories of our podcast guests, you know, we hear from listeners across the nation who are moved to tears, or more importantly, are moved to action to get involved in creative ways. And also to, we hear from foster parents who even change some of their foster parenting techniques and strategies after hearing from former foster youth or other foster parents.
Yeah, I think it's just such an incredible job. And this is something that you guys at home could learn about. It's something you've always wanted to do. What is the one thing you would like to share right now when it comes to foster care with everything that you've learned and done?
Yeah, one thing that's really stuck with me that I didn't realize before I became involved is how cyclical the foster care system is. So we're expecting kids who were never able to be part of a healthy family to then be good parents. And, you know, they say babies don't come with instruction manuals. It's very true. And you're not born knowing how to be a good parent. It's something you learn through experience. And something that I've really learned becoming involved in the foster care system is just the importance of community. And that's really what Just As Special strives to do, is create that community around these kids in care and just encourage people to build lifelong connections as well with kids in care. You know, a volunteer can make a huge difference and change the trajectory of someone's entire life. A mentor can do the same thing. There's just so many different ways to get involved.
Yes. And how do you think this podcast has changed you as a foster parent, even as a person? How has it helped?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it has definitely changed me. I think every single conversation I have with our podcast guests changed me, and it makes me a better person. I'm able to, I think, learn more and more the direct impact my actions have on others, right? Good intentions don't always equal good impact, especially in the foster care system. So just being a lot more aware of what I'm doing and how I'm doing it. And then also to just, I've learned so many new tools and techniques and just practical ways that I can help kids in care. And we actually partner with foster care agencies to provide training for foster parents. And our podcast is a big component of that.
Natasha, for our viewers this morning, if they want to get involved, if they want to check out the podcast, how can they do that?
Right. So you can check out our podcast at justaspecial.com. And we really encourage people to share it with their family and friends. And also, we're looking for virtual volunteers who will work from the comfort of their own home to help us in building out our database of foster care resources. So people can learn more about our virtual volunteering opportunities at justaspecial.com/volunteer.
Thank you so much for all the work that you do and for sharing your story with us this morning. Listen to the Justice Special podcast at justicespecial.com or wherever you get your podcasts. And if you're interested in creating your own podcast, well, join the Colorado community of producers at houseofpod.org.